Yes, please.
Fuck you, Trent.
That's just...
No, that's not the bumper it was supposed to be.
Thanks, Fractal.
That's you, man.
Here we go. Game two. EG, OG, Grand Finals. It's all on the line. Winner gets the pride, the promise, the handshakes, the slaps on the ass, and $10,000.
That was good. I enjoyed that thoroughly. Good work on that
10
one.
10 seconds.
Somebody,
Modpack, you are the earth and Ziori is the hippo.
5 seconds remaining. That's pretty much what just happened to that bumper.
Yeah,
one of the
much.
Players messaged me before the Reserve last series time. Ended and asked, why is third and fourth place the same amount of money? And I'm like, huh. Yeah, we just copy-pasted from the last season when it was single elimination. Should probably change that at some point.
Yeah, we might need to fix that.
Whoopsie. Hey. That was an oversight.
We're real
probably
prepared.
Too late. You get the same money.
Well, or thank you for participating.
Thanks for playing.
Here's your
all right,
money.
Yes, the Terrorblade ban.
Okay, these bans make
right,
sense,
here's,
though.
Here's the picks in this game. Mirana's definitely getting picked. We'll probably see Luna. We'll probably see Shadow Demon.
I'm going to go ahead and say Wraith King won't get picked this game.
I think you're right about that, Andrew.
I'm just putting it out there.
Yeah, you are.
So Darkseer Omni, banned by OG.
What about Nyx Assassin? Good hero.
Let's get some Centaur, man. Let's get some Centaur action.
That
it's time.
Happen. I think Nyx is likely. 5 seconds remaining.
So offlaners are a serious rarity right now, though. We've got Undying still for potential aggro lanes. We've got Centaur, Phoenix. And that's kind of it.
Man, you know you're desperate when you're even mentioning Phoenix. Jeez.
Yeah.
I mean,
I want that
Phoenix
hero.
Is a top-tier pick in this meta.
What? When did we see Phoenix? Was that at Eliminate or Beat?
I don't remember seeing it Beat, but I didn't see every single game.
I just remember watching some Phoenix game and we were questioning it, and I just remember
Yeah,
Purge.
You're talking about the pub that you guys played.
Sure. No, it was definitely not
you
a
know,
pub.
Trent, there was a lot of Phoenix in that Battle Cup replay run that you and I casted.
No, it was not that either.
There was a lot of
I
Phoenix.
I just remember though. Kevin talking Dying a lot about Phoenix and being confused.
Ooh,
so
the good old
Purge
Elder
was flaming
Titan.
It.
All right. Very safe, very strong, very bold.
I like it. I like it a lot. There it is.
Shadow
oh,
Demon
yes.
Luna.
And,
oh, that's what I wanted. Yes.
Yay.
More of this, please.
I called it. I wish I didn't.
Okay.
ET's pretty good against this, though, so.
You know, this could be a setup for Centaur for EG. You've got the Shadow Demon.
Yeah.
Some late Dusa draft or something from
no,
OG,
it doesn't work
perhaps.
With Shadow Demon anymore.
10 seconds
what doesn't?
Remaining.
Centaur.
No, I'm oh, just Centaur. Talking about yeah. disruption into Hoofstomp.
5 seconds
him.
Remaining.
Oh.
That's synergy. Ah, the basic
My
building
God.
Blocks.
Reserve
that
time.
Is amazing.
You actually played
Could you go over how that works?
Well,
it's too
it's
hard to explain.
It's very difficult to execute, let me tell you.
Maybe
it's
Dosen
easier to just look at it.
You have to count to two and then hit Q. My God. The skill cap is beyond
Uncanny.
Me.
Hanny.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Suns Fan here with the Shadow Demon Centaur combination.
OG are thinking hard, man. They're stumped. How do you counter this with only
they're
half the heroes?
They're going to take the Centaur from Shadow Demon.
Yeah, there you go. That's Centaur counters every hero, guys, yeah, except for Bloodseeker.
I mean, well, what have we learned about Shadow Demon Luna in the past Dying months, guys? You know, you guys have been paying attention. Turns out they like to get kind of snowball-y. They come at your towers. Maybe they're going to aggro try at you. That can happen as well. And then they just sit on your little ramp on the other side. They throw some illusions at your towers. Look at this reach now. We got Puck. We got Elder Titan. Some nice combinations there in terms of like some ranged magic damage to burst that squishy old bitch Luna.
5 seconds
oh, Jesus
wow.
Christ.
Wow, this
I love
is
it.
Dark.
I like the puck, though. It's nice.
Reserve
it's cute.
Time.
Cute. It could be an S4 puck, perhaps.
Ooh.
Keep it in mind, I would say.
An offlane S4 puck, for sure.
Yeah, well, yeah, we didn't bring up puck as a potential offlaner. That's
could
a
put
good call.
They could put
it's just
because
there's no
it.
Drow, so it's less likely, but
yeah.
I think it's desperation potentials.
I mean, what do you do against this dual strat, this Shadow Demon Luna? Oh, you pick a... What do you pick here?
Undying.
What do you ban here is
yeah,
the question.
Yeah, Undying.
Undying could work.
Of course, you already have Elder Titan, though, I suppose, so.
I think OG might want to ban, like, Death Prophet-type heroes, like the snowball-y come
Dazzle.
Online early with Luna Shadow Demon.
Did you say Dazzle?
Dazzle, sure. Ban him out. Dazzle Shadow Demon, that's a scary duo. Always.
Yeah,
but they need that lockdown for the puck, though, so it'll probably be, like... Lion or
it's time for No-Tail Meepo to come back.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm down for that.
This could be a really good Meepo game for like fourth or fifth.
I would like EG to go Magnus this game, I think.
Yeah, because I like that.
probably.
Dire team Magnus. Banned.
You know, Sumail likes it.
He does. It's one of his favorite heroes and one of his best heroes. I don't know.
You already have one core that does. That
Storm
good.
Spirit is still in also for Sumail, like we talked about.
Depends on what the other support is for OG, but yeah, in terms of like a puck, it's not that bad.
Yeah.
The lane's fine.
There is a silence, but I mean, it shouldn't be that big.
Yes, that's true. You've got Stomp, you've got Waning Rift.
You shouldn't really get caught by the Stomp anyway. Maybe the Waning Rift.
Ooh. Crystal Maiden ban.
Are they going to go
that's
Chen?
A good hero.
That's the what they're saying. So they're just going to go Chen or Enchantress, depending on what OG don't ban, probably.
So this is push strat then.
Yeah, oh yeah.
For EG.
With Shadow Demon Luna?
You could pick DK as well.
Wild! What
10
else?
10 seconds.
I want to see some Shadow Shaman.
I guess you could Pugna mid and then Luna safe lane if you wanted to.
Shannon, do you think we'll see a mid Shadow Shaman? Will they get that
Absolutely
desperate?
Absolutely not.
I
never.
Wish. I
Although No-Tail used to play that in Han, actually.
Didn't somebody play it in Elimination Mode 1? I remember like we had that conversation talking about how cool it is and they got fucked.
You mean the
up.
Tournament we ran a year ago? How the fuck should I know?
Probably well, first
I thought no it was a memorable impression.
It's been a long time since I've seen a Shadow Demon maybe, but that or Shadow Shaman maybe, but that
5 seconds.
Just call him Rasta Mott.
Sorry, yeah, that's probably easier for me.
You've been on Rasta for a while.
He really likes reserve like, time.
I great. He's yeah. Fun.
I do miss him as solo because he gets his XP way faster.
Nice. Night Stalker's sick.
Ooh.
I like it.
The Night Vision, Luna, Night. You just need Slocky, yeah. Malaki, and Enchantress, please.
Good combination.
Yeah. And it's good to have against Puck, you know. You drop the silence, and that little bird can't do shit.
You could theoretically run him in the offlane people used to. I don't know
10
if he will
seconds
now. He's
remaining.
Not as good. I guess he's probably better in a four position.
5 seconds remaining.
I mean, Faith Beyond did it recently, right?
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
Wait, it's all about who his buddy is, too.
Reserve time.
Yeah.
Buddy well, Faith Beyond. Well, I shouldn't say because they have Universe, so I can't really say anything. Yeah.
Hey, buddy. All right. OG. They have some good setup for team fight already. What if they
took
Winter Wyvern?
That's probably what they're trying to think of, too, right? Like, we already have Elder Giant and Puck in terms of good team fight and everything, but we're up against Shadow Demon, Luna, and a Night Stalker, so there is this really scary moment from around that, like, 12-minute mark scenario.
Whoa!
Wow, that's a good counter to the Vision without heroes like Beastmaster being available.
Yeah.
It also owns Illusions.
Yeah.
So are we looking at position 4 Zeus, then? Or no, maybe mid-Zeus with offlane Sumail Zeus, offlane Puck?
Let's OG. So
wrong team.
Oh, shit.
But yes.
Sorry, there's two G's. My bad.
I know it's tough. Remaining.
Okay. So, okay, same question, though. We still think it's offlane Puck, mid-Zeus?
5 seconds.
Yeah, it feels like they need a heavy building pusher or something here, though, for OG.
I mean, that's an S4 hero, right?
Puck?
Definitely yeah.
I mean,
certainly.
You won a lot of money with it, so.
Certainly, yes.
yeah.
I mean, it could theoretically be S4 Zeus, but I don't think it will be. I think it's more likely a mid-hero. But it depends. Magnus.
I like the Magnus.
Templar Assassin. It's been a while, right? But Templar Assassin still does fine versus Zeus.
Yeah,
that's a very good point.
Dire side.
Elder Titan's roaming in, but it's not that big of a deal, really.
Could be a good TA game.
I think Radiant Team. You should probably make
sure
you have a scaling mid.
I'm surprised OG didn't ban it, honestly.
Yeah. I mean, Kunkka with the Shadow Demon, though. I mean, their bans make sense. But you're right.
I would say DK. I mean, if they're really going for push, I mean, I guess against Zeus, it's not that good.
Definitely Pugna. Pugna's the pick for you.
Yeah, Pugna decrep himself. And
you're just going with it?
I actually do like it. I'm not even kidding.
I like the DK lock as the stun against Puck, too.
DK makes more sense, but I like Pugna more.
He's a good hood builder.
Make a wager, Shannon.
Yeah, he owns Zeus and he owns Puck. Right? And he pushes well. It's pretty good.
Dire team ban.
Oh, Enchantress. They stole it.
Okay.
Counter
Chen. Counter.
Yeah.
Steal the creeps. I like it.
I don't know.
So, kind of confirms core Zeus at this point.
I think I like Night Stalker against Chen.
Yeah, 10 definitely.
10 seconds remaining.
Now they need a carry. And EG needs
5 seconds
a mid.
Yes.
Wonderful. Wouldn't that be funny if we actually got our gyrocopter here now for No-Tail?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Don't
want
it. Hey, Shannon, looking at Pugna as a potential pick, do you see
him? Oh, no!
Oh, it's Spectre. Do you see him more valuable as, like, counter with the ward to heroes like Zeus and Puck that use a lot of mana? or more as a counter to heroes like Lifestealer or Sven or other right clickers that you can decrep and life drain and whatnot?
Both.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, obviously
like
he
it.
Does both.
I like it against spellcasters more.
Yeah,
I think.
The question is which one's more important?
Like Invoker and Zeus just get destroyed by that hero. I mean, okay. Like you can just get a Ghost Scepter to replicate what Decrepify does, right?
Ooh.
Kind of.
I think DK's even.
They now have no stuns for Sumail. They have just silence.
Sure you can. E-Blade, bro.
Yeah, they have no lockdown. That's a good point.
Yeah, it's good.
I think the DK is still really good. Like with the Slark's timing and everything.
I think
and
even more
the,
so
like,
now.
The offlane Puck's timing.
I'm just gonna
too.
Say I called all the night vision here, guys. It's just the wrong team.
5 seconds remaining.
But it makes sense, I guess.
Is EG gonna pick the Storm Spirit?
I think it's possible, but I think the DK is just really hard to say no to.
Yeah, DK is pretty good.
Come on.
Or it could be Viper.
Could be.
And there's also still Morana too, which is worth mentioning. Like,
yeah,
she's still fine.
10 seconds remaining.
Good against Enchantress, you kill her creeps.
Oh yeah, that's nice. Your creep gets stolen, remaining. Just immediately arrow it. Traitor.
Whoa!
It's the Morana.
It is the Morana. Look at that.
All right, good call, Smarty Arties.
I'm sad I called the DK.
So
they
got, man, I love sounding so smart in this mode when there's three mid heroes left.
Enchantress counters Chen and Morana. Counters Enchantress, right? Is that the idea here?
It's going to be a tough creep game.
Life, yes, yeah.
Some
be.
Lion King shit.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't know. What are we thinking here, gang? I kind of like this EG draft.
Same,
Shadow Demon Luna, Chen.
Like
that's pretty nasty.
Definitely
it looks
more
like
standard.
Mode.
Yeah,
yeah
exactly. It does.
What's the win condition
safer.
For OG?
To wreck face.
S4 getting a decently timed blink and going around the map and getting kills with Zeus ult and maybe an Enchantress creep while Slark gets Shadow Blade and then snowball from there.
All about. It's interesting seeing Chen versus Enchantress. But that's not a something we get to see much these days. That's
not
a real
anymore,
treat there.
Anyway.
It used to be more of a thing, right? We'd get your last ban in the second phase, you would ban out the Enchantress or something and then grab Chen.
What do you think, Sunsfan? It looks like you're thinking very hard about something.
No, I'm looking at a tweet that sent a trophy of a ball sack to us, and I just want to thank that person from the bottom of my heart. That
thank
is a great idea.
What a great gift.
Thank you, good friend.
That guy definitely watches the league.
I have to say, my favorite tweet of the day was the one where Pugna actually sent out at Mott Dota, fuck you, Mott, at Moonduck TV, after you praised them. That was pretty great, actually.
The best part was also the reply from Slacks that was just like, what is the context to this tweet, please?
Wow, I really, my self-esteem.
Slacks probably thought we were burning sponsors while he was gone. God damn it, I leave for one day and they're losing us.
I leave for one day.
You guys should probably explain that to him, because he's going to be at Dream League, and he's going to be sitting there with gods, you know. You better make sure you don't lose Sir Action Slacks to BTS.
Oh,
just
no.
Saying.
Gods is going to poach him.
We've lost.
I'm scared.
Goddamn BTS money. And now LA has legal weed, too. All the esports people are going to leave Colorado.
All the memes.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Goodbye, Colorado. California's got everything you have and more.
Arizona lost that vote by 2%.
Did you vote no, you curmudgeon?
I voted yes, actually.
Well done.
Even though I would never partake because I'm not that kind of person. I'm not a terrible person.
Yeah, I know. Whoa. I saw you drink a peach Bellini one time, and you were fucked up. All right, we got some casters for this. It's Mott and Cap once again. Game two, baby. Take it away.
Thank God we got done with that. We're here in game number two where we are in a best of five series. It is, of course, EG versus OG. And Cap, I mean, we see one side has a very standard-looking Captain's Mode draft, where the other side has some crazy stuff going on for OG. But what are you looking at? How are you feeling about both of these drafts?
I'm not feeling real good about OG's, but then again, I mean, they just have a Zeus and a Puck, and those aren't good heroes right now. So,
yeah.
I don't know. We'll see how they perform. You've got a Sumail Morana, you've got this great pushing lineup,
that
and they're going to get First Blood.
Dead Elder Titan. Yep, see you later, First Blood, and maybe a second if they're not careful on OG's side. Now EG will back up. I do want to point out it looks like something happened with a ticket, so we'll be calling these people probably by their hero names, I would imagine. Just going to be easier considering what everyone is named as. It happens.
Yeah, I'm... It looks like they're going to be trying to dodge the aggro tri lane and put what I can only assume is S4's puck at the bottom lane. But this does leave them very susceptible to Chen wrapping around on the Zeus, and that is why that ward needs to be placed right there. Unfortunately, it was just spotted, so that is going to make things a little bit more difficult. So yeah. I was able to get that one.
That's not great. I do want to point out, by the way, the good old combo of like a Shadow Demon and Morana. They're not going to have that unless the Shadow Demon rotates mid, because it looks like the, I would imagine, Sumail is playing the Morana, so in this mid lane.
B-Rabbit.
Yeah. So, I mean, but how about this matchup, Zeus versus Morana? It's not something we've seen that much, actually. It's kind of two different era heroes.
I'm sure Zeus does okay until he gets ganked, but that's probably Zeus in a nutshell. Yeah. That guy's always okay until he gets any pressure whatsoever from a roaming hero. I just feel like Zeus is going to be super susceptible to Chen rotations, and then later on he's going to be having a hard time with Nightstalker, playing that kind of run at you game. Like, even if he just gets off the nuke of the silence, like, that's enough to force Zeus out of the team fight, right? So, I don't know. I'm not particularly optimistic about this Zeus, but we'll see. It's going to be up to the Enchantress to try and be that disruptive force against the Chen and make sure he doesn't actually get a kill on Anna's Zeus.
It's the back and forth between the two jungle controllers. Meanwhile, bottom lane, the puck, which is S4's, is getting pretty heavily harassed by the Luna as well as the Shadow Demon, to be expected. Lucent Beam, Secret Phase Shift, a couple of these auto attacks to try to limit the damage as much as possible. But for now, this is not an easy lane for him. He's sitting at 2 last hits. Meanwhile, in the top lane, the Night Stalker also, he's got 6 last hits himself, so he's doing pretty well, all things considered. They do have the Romeo and Elder Titan. Meanwhile, there's going to be some message shift stacks going. The Pounce will not hit up onto the Night Stalker. He still might be in trouble here. He has 1 Tango, no Fairy Fire, a couple of Mangoes if need be, but they will find the Enchantress now with a Sanders Mentor. He's going to run right into the Creep Wave, but it might not matter. Shockwave should come, and it will. They have the Elder Titan stomp as well. This shard toss from the Mud Golem might do the job here. He's under the tower, and this will be the second kill of the game, as the Night Stalker does fall to a nice gank from the Enchantress.
They do almost kill the Zeus in mid, so it looks like the Chen trying to go in with a Golem. But they are not actually finding successful rotations on him, which is pretty bad because the Chen is, he's playing a stack game right now inside the enemy jungle, but he's fallen a little bit behind in experience compared to the Enchantress.
And with that kill, too, it will help out the Enchantress as well.
Yeah, like, they could easily win 2 out of 3 of their lanes. Nightstalker just died at the top lane, so unlikely he's going to be able to recover from that. But they could still win mid, as well as, obviously, bottom is, like, the freest lane ever for the Luna. Puck represents, like, 0 laning presence power.
Yeah, and they will go on mid again, at least for now. Penitence comes out with the Mud Golem, but they had to dive behind the tower again. They're really putting some emphasis, as you talked about, trying to win this mid lane, but it's just not happening right now. Maybe need to hit an arrow. Still taking a lot of damage is the Zeus. Down bottom, looks like the Shadow Demon has to salve up. They did a lot of damage to the Puck as well with the Soul Catcher. Meanwhile, TPing back out to home is going to be the Night Stalker so that he survives. He doesn't die again. And here we go, though. The Puck has to lose the orb away, but guess what? The Chen is coming. There's the Pendant so they can get this low off. He needs 2 auto attacks, and he has Phase Shift ready. So there's just not really a way for them to get this kill. While this is all happening, Top Point is getting pushed like crazy. OG will take the first tower of the game. They won't get the last hit, but it's still that top tier 1 tower gone.
Yeah, they're definitely proven to be able to have a lot more impact out of their Enchantress with the extra creeps. And the Zeus returns back to lane. Yeah, he's a little bit behind the Morana, but he's still, I would say, pretty happy with where he's at. He hasn't died yet. He's going to get his level 6 soon, and then all of a sudden you became like a mid-Spectre, right? You just require your enemy team to be able to set up a kill for you, and you can be a part of that and get that big boost. Much like a Spectre and Invoker does with their global abilities. Get that extra boost in experience and gold.
Yeah, I think OG are doing all right, all things considered. They do have the bottom lane going pretty poorly for them in S4. S4 sitting at levels even now, around level 3. So he's starting to get some experience. Luckily, he has the creep wave underneath the tower. But here we go. OG, or rather EG, are grouping up together. It looks like we almost had Sumail come down towards this bottom lane, but they have rotated 3 heroes. The Chen will finally come out of the jungle with only level 2, almost level 3. With this creep, he will get it and have another point of Holy Persuasion. But I don't know if they can really take down this tower. There's a couple heroes in the vicinity for OG themselves.
Yeah, it's so hard to play Chen when you only have one creep to work off of against an Enchantress. It's why those mid ganks needed to be successful. They needed to be able to connect that arrow off the golems.
And so far, Sleep, Loser Orb pushing this back. Yeah, I mean, they're just... You can even see they've rotated the Enchantress down. They can enchant a couple of the creeps as well, which is going to be frustrating for the Chen. They can't get anything. They can't get this tier 1 tower. It's only been a little bit of damage they've done, but they clearly rotate everyone from OG to make sure that this tower stays alive, and also makes it a little bit harder for the Luna to get some CS. Meanwhile, S4 getting low again. Lucent Beam was on cooldown, couldn't quite grab the kill. He also phase shifted the last auto attack. But they are keeping this tower up and alive, and they're also getting some good farm mid for the Zeus as well.
Yeah, at the same time, though, they're leaving their Slark out in the cold. Like, Nightstalker clearly wins this.
Silence, they need another Void to get the kill, but it's on cooldown. Plus, there was no mana for it. He actually got into the tree line. They TP and then canceled immediately. Looks like the Puck is going to get the Silence off onto the Shadow Demon down bottom. Disruption coming out. Soulcatcher, stomp. Looking to stop any further aggression. It does hit onto the Luna, but look at this. They're trying to go toe-to-toe with the Shadow Demon. Still has that Soulcatcher up. They need another Lucent Beam, but he's not got the mana for it. Even with the two charges, I don't think he would have the mana for it. Now top lane. The Nightstalker gets caught out. The rotation from the Zeus to help out with the Pounce setup to get the kill. And so they find another kill on the Nightstalker in the offlane, or rather the solo safe lane.
Yeah, the nice pickup of the Infused Raindrop helps save the Slark a lot of grief against that Nightstalker, and they just kind of baited him out with the rotation coming out from Anna. So that was pretty nicely played. The next time that happens, though, probably won't be a successful gank. Sumail will probably be picking up his Moonlight Shadow relatively soon. All things, though, I think OG's, like, they're doing really well. I don't know, they just keep on winning their the laning phase. Like, even the CS last time was in the favor of EG, but this time around, OG are still, I think, winning the laning phase even harder than last time. They EG do give up quick kill, yeah.
They silenced right as the stomp was coming out, and it's something. And they're cutting the creep width, too. They really want to get some pressure out of this tier 1 tower. They're starting to get more room now for the Slark in this top lane as he was getting originally chopped down by the Nightstalker, but as he's rotated, let's see what else happens. Sumail versus the Zeus matchup mid. Looks pretty even, all things considered. Like you talked about, it's rough for Zeus if he gets ganked. So far, that's not happened. However, there is a smoke coming from bottom lane, which OG might expect. It looks like they do. Although, they're walking together, Enchantress as well as the Zeus, and now they have the high ground advantage. They might see some of these heroes rotate. They're really just all going bottom. They've kind of left the Luna here alone. Dream Coil is not up for the Puck. He does get the deny on the tower, though, which is nice. But now they will go back, and they will find the Zeus. And as I talk about him not getting ganked, well, he gets ganked.
Yeah, that was unfortunate. Essentially, he just, like, missed his timing. And, now Enchantress is dead.
Yeah, she stayed way too long. She was stuck in between two separate groups of heroes, one being the Luna and the other being the Nightstalker. And now they're looking for more. The Elder Titan as well as the Slark are trying to hightail it out of there. They rotate down. They don't find anything. They need to leave. And they should be successful. But there it is. Zeus as well as an Enchantress dead. Oh, no. Slark walks right back into the invis of the Moonlight Shadow. In the double Centaur Conqueror stop, but the Zeus ult actually gets the kill. Rather, the Elder Titan using his ability with the Zeus ult comboed up with it on the Chen. So he falls, and they're going to lose another Centaur Conqueror. Somehow, the Slark survives, mostly due to Infused Raindrop, I would imagine, but that's good.
OG, it's still too early for them to really make use of this daytime, but I'm not sure, like, later on into the game, they'll have a certain plan where they group up and they maybe, like, pressure some objectives, but they just don't have the greatest pushing power between the three of their cores. They just have this, like, teamfight presence, but I think Evil Geniuses are just going to take so much of the map over with their Luna pushing power and the early aggression of Nightstalker and Morana. I don't think you can ever beat that.
I mean, this Nightstalker's been in the jungle for the longest time. He almost got another kill. Stomp doesn't hit. He actually cancels it. Look how low he is. Sumail only needs a Starstorm to get it. He will not go in that direction, however. He's looking for the Enchantress instead, and he will hit the arrow nicely.
Nice.
Double Starstorm proc not going to be there. She does have Untouchable, but the Lucent Beam, that was an extraordinarily long-range Lucent Beam that, well, the Luna finds rather easily. And so another kill, 2-0-1, 45 CS, and this bottom lane and this bottom area of the map has been trouble for OG since pretty much the get-go.
Yeah, the problem was, like, last game, OG were able to do well in the laning phase and get themselves a significant lead, but EG did not have heroes to be able to make a comeback after a bad laning phase. You know, they just naturally would get run over. EG, this time around, have very strong mid-game teamfight and objective-taking heroes that will be able to transition a pickoff or two into towers, into, you know, Roshan Aegis. They'll be able to keep the pressure up instead of last game where they just kind of, like, continually got run over by OG. OG can't, like, stay five-man too much, but at the same time, they split up too much. They're risking Nightstalker ganks. If they group up too much, then they're letting Luna free farm the side lanes and letting the Mirana push out lanes. So you're going to start taking some tier two tower damage simply because of creep wave pushes. They walk this very tight line when it comes to movement around this map.
Pretty much, as you said, when you start splitting up, things happen. And that wasn't even the Nightstalker, that Enchantress almost dies. However, Luna might be in trouble. The Moonlight Shadow, the Lightning Bolt will give them the vision. Zeus ult coming out, he's low, but he does finally fall to the Waning Rift and the Elder Titan Stomp. That's a big kill. And now with that, I do want to ask you, I might not have time, however, there are a couple of hero rotations coming in, including the Mirana. It looks like the Elder Titan has been spotted. And, of course, the Shadow Demon Purge. Not to mention the disruption. All of a sudden, EG are coming in and looking to turn this around. Phase Shift coming out with an Ethereal Jaunt as well to get away. And they only get one kill out of that. It is going to be the Elder Titan. But I did want to ask you real quick about the... You talked about the potential of comeback for EG in the first game. How is the potential comeback factor for OG here in the second game? I mean, not that they're that far behind anyways.
Yeah, you're anticipating that EG will take control of the mid game, right? So OG will have to try and stall out. I don't think their comeback is that strong. Slark is probably probably the best carry that was left, to be honest. They needed a hard carry that would be slippery enough that it could split push while the other heroes do a certain amount of four manning. He needed to be a hero that wasn't susceptible to Nightstalker, so Slark was pretty much your last carry left, but I don't think that he's going to be able to take advantage of heroes split pushing that well. His objective right now, or a little bit later on to the game, is to be shutting down Samael whenever he tries to go for a split push. But when it comes to EG 5-manning, he can't really accomplish that much, right? The mid-game Slark. Yeah. So they have to go, like real big late game, you know, where the Slark gets his Scotty and stuff. And I don't think that they're going to have a big time where they come back in this game.
That arrow, it's going to be a trade, a one-for-one. It looks like the Shadow Demon more than willing to give his life up. But here comes the Eclipse, and the Zeus will fall instantly. Lucent Beam onto the Enchantress. They can't go further than that Tier 2 tower, nor do they want to. But they still take a two-for-one advantage in that fight. And it's exactly what you're talking about, fighting at all five of these heroes for EG. Slark's off split pushing, doing his own thing. They can't really contest that type of tower. They did get a kill, but they went a little too hard, perhaps, for that Shadow Demon.
It says a lot about this game, right? That he would hand a Midas and not Shadowblade or Blink Dagger or something, right? He knows how much farm he has to get in order to contest these cores. So I think, again, hand a Midas is probably the best thing you could go for in this game, but it still feels like a really shitty option. It's just there are too many things that OG need to do correctly in this game to be able to stay within a window, right, of being able to fight EG and not just getting run over by them constantly in the mid game. And right now, none of those objectives are really being taken besides the pickoff on the Luna at the bottom lane. That was a really good play by them. Nice rotation. And if they could do it a second time, that would be huge.
It's going to be tough. They have the Zeus as well as the Puck. She has an Ogre Club. The Dream Quail will go. The raindrops are gone now. It won't be as tough as I thought. They blow her away. No Zeus ult necessary. It's all really just the Dream Quail, Waning Rift, Arc Lightning, and Lightning Bolt that does the job there. So, all right.
I like this split push coming out from the ET. If he just TPs away, I think
he's probably...
He could have just TP'd away, but...
Yeah, Samael is rotated in. His arrow is back off cooldown. Pendant's coming out Void. I mean, yeah, the arrow actually gets the kill from long range. Samael will pick it up.
Yeah, we of course knew there was double Hellbear Smashers, so there's nothing from the Jens army that could have stopped them there. So he just instantly TP'd, but obviously there's no way for him to be able to know that. So they've got the Hand of Minus on the Nightstalker, so Universe is going to be able to make some pretty good timing into his late game Aghanim / Gem, kind of no matter what happens. So I like that choice.
Too, yeah, Boy comes out, no Dark Axe, Starstorm. The double proc, and he gets killed by the arrow again, and this is just a lack of vision coming out of the map for OG. Not that, I mean, they weren't It's tough to be able to be prepared for that type of gank, especially with a Night Stalker and a Silence. The nighttime comes out, and it becomes very difficult for a Slark to see that kind of gank coming in. It puts him behind even further.
Yeah, there's many reasons that Mirana is strong right now, but Moonlight Shadow is just like one of those extra bits. It's like having free smokes to utilize, you know? Like, smoke ganks are like sometimes guaranteed kills just because the initiation surprise and what happens, like, you just can't really deal with that. It's kind of like, okay, the smoke gank gave you a guaranteed kill, and that's the trade-off. But right. With Mirana, it's like the Moonlight Shadow is almost better in some ways. Like, for example, here, it catches the Slark before he can get Dark Pact. You know, you can always silence ahead of him.
And it's not easy.
I don't know. This
is game.
Yeah, this is not a great time. Zeus, I don't know what you do with this hero.
You hope that you can take a big team fight. I don't know.
I mean, they're looking to just hold the rest of these towers now that they have Zeus with his max out lightning bolts. He's got some static field charges. He almost has Veil of Discord. They're looking to be able to stop the pushes of EG. But the thing is, it's not just a five-man death ball from EG, right? Like, they can always split push you, too. They can always take the other two lanes when you're five-man trying to defend a top lane. They can easily just go to the other lanes because they've got so much map control with a Night Stalker. It just opens the map up a lot for you to be able to accomplish these sorts of things. Like, Samael almost has his Aghanims. He's 4-0-3. He's ahead of the Slark despite the minus pickup.
So is the pressure on then during the daytime for OG to find stuff, or are they still just trying to hold towers when it comes to daytime?
Yeah, I was trying to think. Like, early game, you know, there was very limited amount what you could do, but now that we're like 16 minutes in, what's it going to look like 24 minutes in? I don't know what these daytimes are actually going to look like for OG. I'm sure they have to do some sort of group up and pushing, but it's not like EG all of a sudden are afraid of pushing towers. They still have darkness to be able to fall back on. Yeah. If you try and defend a tower or something. So I honestly don't know what OG's plan is going to be besides just trying to draw out the game for the Slark to become bigger. For you to be able to have a really good amount of high ground defense out of your Zeus, you know, it's the late game plan. You know, it's like the third part of the plan that seems kind of obvious. OG will try and, you know, hold their high ground, give Slark the space to be able to do Slark things, and that's how they're going to go. But how do you prevent EG from going high ground before 25 minutes? You know, what does that transition period look like for OG that I am kind of questioning? And a lot of that comes down to the fact that you have a Zeus, which is not the biggest playmaking core in the world. You know, he needs heroes to be able to. You have to draft around a Zeus, not you just can't pick up a Zeus to pick up a Zeus.
You still have some good tempo controllers even without the Zeus, and he can get involved. If you're like, if it's right now in daytime and you smoke up and you try to find a kill with the Slark and you get one pick off, that extends the game longer, and so the Zeus can use the Zeus ult to help out with that kill. But it just feels like EG are a step ahead of them in that regard. They're always the ones trying to find kills. Even when it comes to daytime, as you can see now, they smoked up. They thought about going to the high ground here in the jungle, and instead they'll take Roshan. And that's rough if they can't contest for OG.
Yeah, it's like it's supposed to be this big win. Like, I successfully spoiled your smoke gank with my Thunder God's Wrath.
Yes.
And EG are just like, whatever. We'll just do Roshan, right, Roshan with this. Who cares? You know? So... and they're going to do it so quickly that it's not much of a momentous pause for OG to take map control.
OG are trying to move over, but by the time they get there, at least it should be dead by the time they get there. The ET, the stomp might be enough.
Get it!
He needs to get there in time. It's just not. The Dreamcrawl is not a 2. They blow one away. This Aegis might be gone next here as well. The Silence, one more auto attack. They need to get the Shadow Dance up, but he was silenced the entire time through. The Slark, the big playmaker, will fall for OG, and who's going to be next? Good Centaur Conqueror stomp. Good Waning Rift. Going to lose Europe, but they just don't have the damage yet. Meanwhile, Zeus getting chased down. He realizes he's in trouble. Disruption will come out. They have the Soul Catcher as well. The Star Storm should do more than enough. It's actually a Lucent Beam from the Luna as the Mirana is chasing elsewhere. And they'll look for more. Meanwhile, look at the Puck going in super aggressively.
God,
now it looks like the Eclipse is going to come out and they blow him away. S4, he felt like he had to make something happen there and he gets punished for it. It was so close, Cap. They took down the Luna. They got the Aegis. Yes, they lost the Slark, but it would have been a 2-for-1 at that point in time. Had they just got the Aegis, had they got out, had the Aegis not been there, but they were a little too late to the party.
Yeah, that was sad to watch. Yes. You know, if you're just a little bit, they're a little bit faster, then all of a sudden we have a real ball game on our hands, right? Because OG, if they kill the Luna and there is no, there is no Aegis picked up, or maybe they actually snatch the Aegis in time or something, then that team fight could actually go even for OG, and they would give themselves a very large window to be able to work with. But now it's pretty much just back to the norm. Like, nothing really good happened for OG in that fight. They took away the Aegis, but it's not like EG were looking to push high ground with that Aegis. No. That was the controlling Aegis. You know, it's the I'm going to take all your outer towers Aegis, and you can't do shit about it.
Let me choke you out, take your entire map kind of Aegis.
Yeah, instead they got a Solar kill for it. All right, we're pretty happy with that. They're going to complete the Aghanims on Sumail. They're going to complete the Ags on the Night Stalker, and this is when things get really scary, right? Is when the Ags and Gem is up on the Night Stalker, you have no map control, so you naturally have to group up. You just have to, otherwise you get give away free picks all day, every day. Yeah. So EG either outfight you, or they always get the initiation.
And this is just, it's getting tougher and tougher for OG as the game progresses, that Aghanim Scepter, as you mentioned. And he does have it soon, sending about 600 gold away. Meanwhile, of course, Sumail already has his. How much can the Slark accomplish? How much can he farm? He has an Echo Saber. He's got his Midas. But really, the only item that he has is Triad's Echo Saber. That's all that he's really getting. Doesn't really have the most survivability in these fights just yet. Doesn't have the most damage. He's more S and Shift stacks if he wants to be able to fight throughout a long engagement. And all really you need to do for EG is find a silence on him to start things off, and he can't get his Dark Pact off, and then he just dies. Oh, God, just to make sure they keep up their creeps. They go home, and I don't know, when do EG push? Do they wait for the next Roshan? Do they need to farm anymore? The Luna's not quite at that Godzilla point, so maybe you wait for her Manta style?
I think it's Roshan number 2 that you go high ground with, that second Aegis. They can easily use this Ags gem to be able to push the Outer Towers. I don't think they have to wait for Aegis for those objectives, but they should wait for Aegis for the high ground push. They just need to close off the map. That's what their job is going to be for the next 5 or 6 minutes.
EG looking
that axes up
series. Yeah, this is a tough position for OG. They're up one game as it stands now, but EG are looking to turn this back around and get to a third game with a 1-1 series tie. We haven't talked much about the Zeus. He's picked up his Veil. He's now working on what is to be his Aetherlens, which is to be expected at this point. So he will have some damage. He will have some extra range to work with. There's a Blink Dagger coming out for the Slark, and he's not going to go for the Shadowblade, which makes sense considering he is up against the Night Stalker. But what do you think about the Blink Dagger pick overall in general?
It's kind of... He's got to get the initiation on the Marana in some ways. I don't know. It doesn't really feel real good because you're not going to scale as well into the late game like you wanted to. But you also know that you have to fight EG. You just can't concede every part of map control. So OG's objective here is they need to get a really good fight in 2 minutes time when it's daytime, and ideally the Night Stalker will still have the gem on his person even though it's daytime. You smoke up, you try and get that one fight that gives you the gem, even if it costs you, even if it's an uneven trade. As long as you get the gem away from Evil Genius's hands, then you have a chance to be able to have some semblance of map control. You cannot afford to let that controlling item stay in Evil Genius's hands.
Uh-oh. Sumail's been caught. Do they have detection? Lightning Bolt coming again here. The Droop Crawl comes out. The Pounce gets the kill. He wanted to get that regen rune, and that gives a lot of gold away to the Slark as he picks it up, and it's a dominating spree. Yes, they do lose their tier 1 tower in the top lane. Now they're coming home maybe to defend this all together. There's going to be the disruption coming out. Slark is in, or rather, excuse me, the Puck is in the tree lines, but they do see this, or at least they should on the Dire side. Blink in, Waiting Rift, Droop Crawl already used. They're going to use the Elusive Orb to jump back out. Eclipse is going. Uh-oh.
No,
see you later, Zeus. He's down for 45. The Zeus ulti was used. Slark coming in now, looking for the Luna. He's going to get sent home in time. Do they have the damage? And it looks like no. He will get out in the nick of time, as it looks like Chen will be the next to be at least trying to be taken down by OG. And Zhao Pi, of course, doing a very good job of... he tried his best to juke, I should say. I had to stop for a moment. I was like, it was a good effort. But unfortunately, it was just not there. But if they could have gotten Luna as well, that would have been so huge for OG there, Cap.
Yeah, this is the fun part, though, for Universe, right? He's like, okay, all your heroes are top. I'm just going to sweep through your bottom half of the map because I know you had control of that, 2 to 4 minutes ago. So you probably laid down some wards. So it just clears out all the vision. And then from there, Arteezy feels really comfortable being able to farm this bottom lane. Sumail will always make sure that mid and top lanes, you know, whatever opposite side of the map Luna is, then Sumail just goes to the other side and he just, like, pushes out real quickly because he's got this Aghanim Starstorm that instant kills creep waves.
Well, he might die.
Oh,
he
gets there's a catch.
Yeah, this could be another death. Sumail nice. Dies twice in a row. The Zuzul actually gets the kill. Uh-oh, Nightstalker, you've got that gem. You can't go too far. They did have the Shadow Demon for support nearby. Any sort of defensive abilities would have been used there. The Mantis Tile done for the Luna, but now down for 50 seconds. And here the Slark goes onto this Tier 1 tower. The Glyph will go. It's in deny range. How far are they willing to go to try to take this tower down? There's not every hero here for EG. And it will get taken by the Slark. All of a sudden, Cap, it's looking, I don't want to say that bad for EG, but it's starting to look a little bit sketch.
I mean, OG are giving themselves a chance, right? This Blink Dagger did exactly what it needed to do.
Yep.
They got two pickoffs on Sumail. They know that he's going to be the one hero who is the highest net worth hero that they can easily kill if they just catch him when he's split pushing. Because more likely, evil geniuses are going to be surrounding their Luna a little bit more often, right? They're going to be trying to protect Arteezy's farm, make sure he gets that BKB and such. It's going to be Sumail who briefly shows up in a lane, you know, stops the push with his Starstorm and then backs out. So this Blink Dagger is supposed to take advantage of that. And I think it absolutely has. It's given them a chance to be able to control some of this early to mid game before evil geniuses hit the second Aegis window.
I will say this much. If that's how much damage the illusions do to the Slark, that is not a good sign when it comes to fighting this Luna. She's not even that farmed yet, but already you could see that was not a good not a good little fight for the Slark. Like, that's never a good indication of how this game is going. Still, though, they will take down the Tier 1 tower for OG. They will push into the Tier 2, do some significant tower damage, including a little bit below the half health of the tower. And EG, they've accomplished a lot. They haven't gotten all of the outer towers, but now they are en masse going towards the bottom lane, looking for the Slark. He does have a Blink Dagger. He's going to need to use it. Dark Pact is going to come out, blinks away. He's got the pound still, and he gets out just in time. There wasn't really any Radiant Observer Wars to see that coming, but he just knew something was amiss as the illusions came through.
I think OG, if they can get another smoke and contest Roshan, even just get themselves, even if they give up the Aegis, but even if they just have like a decent fight where they trade off and they prevent evil geniuses from five manning into the last tier twos and going high ground, then I think OG have given themselves a pretty good window, right? They would have gotten into the mid game where 35 minutes in, they've got, you know, pretty good high ground defense in the Zeus and the Puck with the Elder Titan combination. Like, Zeus is a great high ground defender, but when you get free natural order as well, like, he's going to be really tough to push into.
Yeah.
They won't be able to just freely illusion push into lanes because those illusions are going to die so quickly. So there isn't going to be a very quick way for evil geniuses to be able to end this game if OG can contest the next Roshan.
My question is, though, I mean, yes, you have really good high ground defense for OG in a lot of instances, but you look at EG, you have a Luna and you have a Mirana, two pretty good scaling heroes, even the Nightstalker scales rather well. You have a Zeus as well as the Enchantress and Puck. Do you think they can scale evenly with EG given enough time? Or is it really just all on the Slark's shoulders when it comes to the late game? At least when they're if you're trying to push their high ground and not defending your own.
I don't want to underestimate Zeus too much. And the later game potential of Puck is not terrible if he gets like Ags or Scythe, and he's a strong initiator at that point. So, but I think more of it is going to be on the Slark's shoulders and how he performs. And he's already got a catch.
Yeah, he's got it. Sumail again. They'll drop the sentry though. He just doesn't have the damage on his own. They didn't want to use the Zeus ult, nor was it up. Anyways, with 18 seconds on cooldown. They have the Moonlight Shadow going now, so the Nightstalker on the hunt himself. He's got good vision. He knows exactly where the Slark is, not necessarily where the rest of the team is. And then Luna just heads right back towards the bottom lane and continues to farm. So they don't get that kill on Sumail. He's going to try again. This time the pounce misses. He gets up to the high ground, luckily enough. He had pounced to the river. That might have been trouble. Arrow's going to come in, and he misses it narrowly. That almost hit him. He would have dark packed it. But they're getting a little bit more aggressive. They're getting a little bit more antsy here, it looks like. Cap, I don't want to say antsy, but confident, I suppose.
I mean, I think in some ways OG are a little antsy. They would really like to be able to get a pick off because they know Roshan is coming up. And it's also the fact that evil geniuses are able to do Roshan so quickly. And there isn't normally there's an advantage to the team who is invading into the Roshan pit when a team is already doing it. But that advantage isn't there against a Nightstalker. That's just one of the many things that Nightstalker Axe gives you, is that his clear vision prevents you from being able to get, you know, a nicely positioned team fight, because you, like, EG will always see that rotation coming a mile away. So in that case, they really want that pickoff just to be able to give themselves a bit more of a fighting chance to contest Roshan, or at least delay it.
Mm-hmm.
And again, prevent that Aegis 2 timing that is so common on Luna strategies. but it just does not seem to be possible. Evil geniuses aren't really giving them too much of a window.
Yeah, it's,
they're sticking around that mid lane quite a bit.
Yeah, there's this kind of collapsing playstyle from EG right now. They'll farm out the side lanes quickly, they'll move together, and then kind of meet back in the mid lane or around this area. And now, especially with Roshan, they're going to just sit together here and just take this as quickly as possible. Roshan back up. You do have now a couple more items coming up from OG, but again, with the Night Stalker, with it being nighttime as it is right now, it just doesn't seem like there's a possibility for contention. They can try, but we'll have to make a decision soon whether or not they want to go for it. You can already see that the Slark is blinking forward aggressively, perhaps looking to clear out his own jungle, heading towards the Rosh Pit. It's not at half health yet, so it's not falling as quickly as it could be, but it looks like OG are not in the position to contest. At least they're backing for now.
Yeah, so free Rosh. They smoke up, but the Aegis is definitely going to go to EG, but they may still be able to fight around this pit somehow.
I don't know. It's not falling that quick. They still aren't really going in. There's no real desperation from OG. It looks like they're losing yet. The Zeus ult comes out.
Wow.
There's the Dream Coral on it, too. They wanted four. Couldn't quite get a BKB. Now the Slark forced to pop the Shadow Dance. They want the Shadow Demon, but he disrupts himself very quickly. Now the Enchantress has to force himself away. They've already lost the puck, and it looks like they might lose more. Good TP from the Zeus, but now with that, this should be the end of the fight, and it should be Roshan going to EG, perhaps even more. They've lost one for one on both sides. There's the second kill with the Starstorm and the Silence on top. And it looks like
go
the
Slark!
Tetris.
Oh, he got
gets
it!
The Slark! He gets the Snatch! He can get out now. He has no TP scroll. He's going to get voided in silence. He's got Pounce in 2 seconds. If he can last through that silence, he might be able to make it away. No, the Aegis will go. And can they bring him down a second time? He has Blink Dagger as soon as he's back up, and he will use it to get down to the Ancient Stack. Meanwhile, on the other side, you actually have the Enchantress looking at the Luna. But nothing happening there. Slark is still running on his own. Pounce is back up in 3. Dark Pact to get off the void. The silence is there, but not quite in range of it. And so the Slark can get out. It's the Snatch that comes in. And the Luna brings down the Zeus solo. Or excuse me, the Mirana, not the Luna. And she just jumps in, gets a couple of quick Starstorms. Should do the job. It was a good attempt from OG. But the BKB that came out from the Luna making it a lot more difficult for OG to fight into that.
Yeah, so they took away the Aegis, but I still think that was a significant enough net worth and experience gain for Evil Geniuses that they're okay with this. They've got the BKB. He used one charge, but he's still got a 9 second magic immunity for their next push. So I think everything is in order for Evil Geniuses to go high ground. They even got a BKB on the Night Stalker and Samael. They could wait for his Ethereal Blade if they really wanted to. I think he could probably pick that up by 35 minutes, but it's really up to, I guess, the opportunities that's presented, you know, because Nightstalker always has such a great mid to late game advantage once he has that Aghanim's that you never feel rushed, you know, your traditional timings that on any kind of push, like say this is like a really like a single core Dro Ranger lineup that usually, you know, needs to go high ground by 30, 35 minutes or else you're going to start screwing yourself out of time. Well, that, you know, even if it was that kind of lineup, EG would not feel pressured because Nightstalker always gives you an advantage when it comes to map control. It always gives you the opportunity for a easy pickoff or something like that.
Right.
So Evil Geniuses can just buy time and wait for a pickoff like that. Wait for some sort of mistake by OG or a superior initiating opportunity for EG. There's so many things that could be had for them here. I also like what they're doing with Zai's Chen, where he's the one split pushing some of these side lanes because the Mirana's had a rough time of it dealing with the Slark and his Blink Dagger Pounce. So you'll see that Chen is more often pushing the lane that is farther away from the Luna. So the Mirana is staying closer to the team because the Chen's able to output that split pushing power instead.
It's just the simple positioning advantage that EG have, and again, a lot of that is due to the Night Stalker in the nighttime. It is daytime, however. Night Stalker's ultimate is back up in 26 seconds, so just something to keep in mind. And it looks like they knew this timing was here, so they smoke up and they're looking for something, and this is probably the perfect time for it. And they want to take a fight outside the base. The unfortunate thing is they might not find anybody. The Luna would be the primary target. They will see the illusions coming down, and they will head to the north now and assume. And now with the ward there, too, they can try to find a jump. There's the Veil coming out. The Dream Pearl's there first. The BKB is popped. It's just so difficult to be able to take that hero down without chain disables, and she was running a little too quickly for them to bring her down with those chain disables.
Yeah, it was also pretty dirty. Did you see what Crit was doing with Arteezy's illusion? They found an illusion rune, and they just kept one of the illusions on crit in that bottom lane, and he was just constantly disrupting and throwing those illusions to push out the bottom lane.
That seems ridiculous.
Yeah, so they've got total map control now. As long as they don't lose some ale.
He's going to Yule's himself for now and leap away as well. Zeus ult, not enough damage still. Air's going to come through. They have the TP coming out. This actually might be successful. The Chen does make it away, which is pretty impressive. They do find Sumail again. Leaps down up for 6 seconds. Hand of God, but now the bash comes out from Sumail. And so they almost got the Chen, but he stayed too long himself. He's dead for 70 seconds with no buyback. Again, Sumail falls, and it's just a little bit of hope coming out for OG here, Cap.
Yeah, this is... Those pickoffs on Sumail, man, they have really been keeping OG in this game. Slark is now... He's beginning to make that transition into late-game power. I think this is probably one of the more awkward periods for OG. If they can get over this last hump, then I think they have a very solid chance of being able to win the late game.
Bounce somehow hits up. Wow, that was... There was no ward there. He just did it randomly. He's just trying to go for the Dark Troll Summoner, I think. He just ends up getting a kill easily on the Chen, which now is another hero gone. And all of a sudden, your Tier 2 tower is being taken. Luckily enough, you have a Luna Illusions, which are pretty good for clearing creep waves. Not that it matters, though, as the Slark has taken down the tower himself. His Abyssal Blade is on the way. He has a Manta Style as well. Not only that, they have the Aghanim Scepter for the Puck. So the Dream Quill, if they break the coil, the stun will go through Magic Immunity. That's the important thing to note. And the Puck is going to back away.
Means there's no easy escape for the Luna. You know, that's going to be their target. They could just always initiate on him, pop the coil. On him or the Mirana, and then Slark can just go in, and even if the Luna tries to turn and, you know, pop the Eclipse or something like that, then Slark can just go ahead and pop his ultimate and continue to wail on the Luna.
Oh, all right. Well, see you later, Elder Titan. Goodbye. Ethereal Blade, Arrow, Void, dead. It's that simple.
I think this is probably one of the strongest timings for EG. I think this is where their lineup reaches a very serious peak. Is in that 35 to 40 minutes where the Luna has finally gotten to a point where you actually fear all that physical damage he's outputting, and the Mirana is at a peak when it comes to magic damage as well because you have the Ethereal Blade, and then obviously you have the vision advantage with the Nightstalker. So this is why I call it like that last awkward hump for OG, because this is going to be one of the toughest times where they have to try and stop the five-man from EG from going high ground, finally.
Yeah.
If they can get over that, then the Slark becomes a really... He may actually be able to out-carry this Luna with his progression and items.
Well, as for right now, it's just not going to be the case. Luna is a butterfly. He does not have an MKB ready, which means this Luna is, I don't want to say invulnerable, invincible, but it's very, very difficult to take down. I do like what they're doing, though, in the top lane. The Puck just moves up, split pushes quickly, and now this forces at least one hero back. Yes, they can clear out the waves quickly with Starstorm and what have you, but at least they are making sure they are not fighting yet. Make him try to go for that third Aegis. Make him go for that third Roshan. Make them find a pick. And EG, I mean, they're not in a bad position yet. They still have a pretty high net worth advantage, which we haven't really checked since the beginning of the game. It's a 10,000 net worth lead. An experience lead about 8,000. But they still have pretty good control of this game.
Yeah, I still think Evil Genius is, even if they don't, like, take a Rax by 45, I still think they have, like, maybe a 60% chance to be able to win the game.
That's a Scythe on a Shadow Demon also.
Huh.
Yeah.
How did Crit manage to do that?
I guess they just... Someone else bought all the wards and the sentries for a while. More than likely Chen, I would imagine. Silence? Uh-oh. He's going to go for it, though. He's going to look for the pounce, and now Ethereal Blade comes out, but not on the right target. Shadow Dance is going to come through. There's the Hand of God after the Zeus ult. Still, he's still in trouble. Now the Glimmer KP will finally fall, but it's a one-for-one. The Zeus falls on the other side, pounce away as the Slark needs to get out. Waiting Rift will go onto the Shadow Demon. Now Sumail looking for more damage on the Slark. Arrow's not going to connect. He's got his Ethereal Blade back up to 3. The Abyssal Blade comes out. Do they have the damage here? It looks like they don't. They have to back up and away now as the Luna is on the run. The Puck coming back in. Ethereal Blade phase shifting it. Waiting Rift coming out. Not yet. He's looking for more. The Luna trying to fight as best as possible. Slark is all over the damn place. Earth Splitter with a stomp. It's only going to hit onto the Night Stalker for now. Blink out coming from the Puck. Lucid Beam going to connect. Still stunned. Jaunting away everybody low from OG with the exception of the Elder Titan, but he might be the cannon fodder here. Lucid Beam connects. They get the kill. The gem is on the deck. The Luna still no BKB. Mantis style pop. A lot of damage being taken. There's the Hex. The Silence is up as well, but he's forced back into the well. Forced back into the base. The Ethereal Blade. He's sitting at 200 HP, and now Sumail has caught himself diving too far. He'll fall. They bring him down with the Zeus getting the kill, who does buy back into the fray. You can see that they're looking for the Shadow Demon next. The Glimmer Cape is gone. The Lightning Bolts is there. He's up on the high ground. They don't have the damage. He TP's out in time. The Slark was looking elsewhere for more damage and more kills. But they do get the kill again on Sumail. The buyback does have to come from the Zeus cap, but all in all, that's not a bad fight for OG.
Oh man, they lost the gem. I was checking on if they managed to carry the gem, but yeah, and Crit was able to snag that and get out with his TPs. So I think that that's a really unfortunate part, because one of the things you're looking to do against the Nightstalker Axe is you're looking to, during daytime, equalize the vision, right? So you go push out and you try and take away whatever aggressive wards are laid down by EG. So at least you know you're equally blind, right? During daytime.
Right.
But that is no longer going to be the case. OG, I have to say though, I did not like OG's draft, so I think that from a play perspective, I think OG is doing very well. I did not anticipate them being able to give themselves such a good fighting chance against the what we kind of call the more traditional lineup, right? Yeah. For EG, they've got a pushing lineup we've seen plenty of times.
It's getting sketchier and sketchier for EG as the game goes on. The Slark is now top in the net worth, which means a lot, but he still needs to be able to find these kills on this Luna or be able to at least get some more in these team fights. Now with Roshan up, though, it is going to be third time the charm, perhaps, because, of course, you have the Aegis, you have the cheese ready. We picked up for EG, and then I don't think they are going to be able to get there to contested time, so I imagine EG look for a final push, or at least to try to get to the high ground once and do some damage there. Wait and see. They're going to give the Aegis to the Luna, and the cheese is going to be picked up, looks like, perhaps, by the Shadow Demon, and it will be.
Yeah, I'm just hold on to it until the Luna needs it, most likely. Sumail's beginning to get that progression into more late game magic damage, so he's gonna get the dag in.
He's got some burst.
That Slark really needs an MKB, but it doesn't look like that's his item choice.
Well, he has the quarterstaff. He's going for the butterfly, it seems to be. For
like most team fights, Slark's job is not to go on the Luna. It's to go on the Priestess of the Moon, and it's to go on the Shadow Demon and force out the defensive disruption. Like his job is to give OG a numbers advantage in team fights by killing the weaker heroes in the back line.
Hex is up, and he won't be able to lose more about in time now. And this looks to be a dead puck. He does have buyback. Can he blink up? Looks like he might be able to, yes, but now with 13 HP, this disruption will almost certainly kill him with the Shadow Poison on top of it, and it will. Again, he does have buyback, but the Scythe, he Glimmer Cape Scythed, was not expecting that. They were all backing together, but he was not ready for the initiation from the Shadow Demon, who has now purchased up a Blink Dagger with that kill.
Yeah, before it was like, the Scythe was kind of like a novelty item, you know? It was like, oh, this could be good in like really certain, you know, special scenarios. But now, when coupled with the Blink Dagger, he is a hardcore initiator. He's going to be one of the few people who can actually punish Slark when he's on the front lines trying to prevent these pushes. You know, because normally he's so reliant on falling back on Dark Pact that he feels comfortable against these kind of heroes going forward, because he can always see the initiation coming. But not potentially against this Blink Dagger Scythe of the Shadow Demon.
Right, and there's more big items too for EG, which is the big concern for OG. It just keeps getting worse and worse, as now there's an Assault Kiros for the Luna. I don't know what she's dropped. Looks like it's the Helm of Dom. Makes sense. Also the treads too. He has Butterfly, Flutter, Movement Speed, so that works just as well.
Yeah. AC is a particularly needed item against the Elder Titan. I wouldn't have been surprised to see the AC before the Butterfly because of how important that Elder Titan aura is.
Yeah.
But because they had so much magic damage, he probably felt more comfortable with the Butterfly.
Just one with flat armor.
That the AC wasn't, the AC wasn't fully required. If there was a lot of physical damage, he probably would have picked up AC much earlier in this game.
It's just now another luxury item coming out. The puck is top lane splitting and pushing us to is the Slark. They want to make sure they can get this wave out first and foremost. But here comes the high ground pressure with the tier 3 tower down bottom about to fall. They have the glyph. They will not use it yet. They will probably use it for the racks. Wait and see here. Everyone alive for both sides. Buyback status is pretty good, but not not that much for the Slark. He doesn't have it. He will go on top of this Luna. He still has that Aegis with the butterfly, not doing too many hits. He has to use the Shadow Dance. So now that's on cooldown for 50 some odd seconds, which is pretty important.
I think in some ways, you always have to initiate on a Luna before she takes your tier 3 tower. As soon as she takes that, it's so hard to push it in, or push against EG, because it just starts bouncing to all that back line.
Yep. They're trying their best here. They went for a pounce on the Nightstalker, but he's able to get out. The pounce was going to miss from the Slark. Another arrow coming through. They're doing a good job of clearing out the creep wave for OG. Now they're looking for another initiation. They're going to go on the Nightstalker. Pops the BKB. Now that's forced out. Silence comes through. Force away. Yule Scepter as well into the puck. It's his own Yule. So he's going to be able to get out, but now gets hexed up still pretty far back. Now the Slark is alone. The Eclipse coming through. The Luna wants to kill everybody on the OG side, and he might do a good job of it. Abyssal Blade trying to bring down what looks to be the Chen, but he's still alive. And they bring down the puck. They bring down the Slark. They have to buy back. It's a 3-for-2. Meanwhile, it looks like they will lose the Luna, but that is just the Aegis. They've also lost the Marauder. The only person in the back line for EG is going to be the Shadow Demon. They will find the Luna a second time, trying to get the Mailer Axe, and he will before going down.
Oh, he got the Enchantress.
And he gets the Enchantress as well. Those Glaives are too damn powerful. And yes, they have to buy back, but they do hold, and it is a lot of gold that they get out of it, with the exception of the Slark, who loses a fair bit of his own.
Yeah, the Slark losing gold, normally I would say that's a pretty big win for OG, because I think prolonging the game and everything is just important for them, but the fact that Slark lost gold on that team fight, really, it really does suck, right? Because he's the guy you need to scale the most. He's the guy who needs to get an MKB and a Scotty eventually for him to be able to contest the Luna a bit better. But I think OG, they can actually do a lot here, because I think Luna does not want to buy back at all.
Yeah, she's the only one that can, but they've got to get in the base together, and they got to do it within the next 20 seconds or so before the Marauder's up. The Chen being alive, the Shadow Demon being alive, they can deal with that. They want to get this Mailer Axe and even it up right now. Glyph will go, 13 seconds still before Sumail is back up and alive. Goon Captain, you can see, get Silence before going to get the Disruption off, but he does get Hexed in the meantime. The Puck, now Pendant's damage will come out. They get the Mailer Axe, they've accomplished it. Now they need to get out. Pounce through. He doesn't pounce to the low ground. Dark Pact will go first. Blink is up at 3. Still in trouble. The Void comes out. Silence isn't there. Level 25. He's got the pounce ready to go. He will make it away. The arrow's not going to connect. They're still hunting. Moonlight Shadow has gone. They get a bait this. No, Slark. Looks like they're just going to back together as a team. I don't know how far you go if you're EG. You do not have your Luna. You can see how aggressive the Nightstalker is. He is alone. There was the Radiant Observer Ward. If they wanted to turn back around, they might have gone for him. But they are more than happy, Cap, with getting that kill on the Mailer Axe and being aggressive there.
So, Anna played that really well. Apparently Anna is playing the
Slark. Yes.
The Slark.
Yeah, because I remember No-Tail was orange. I go based on the colors. Orange is No-Tail last game. So,
I think Anna's playing the team fights really well. I think Anna's had an exceptional game. Like, he is keeping OG in this. Like, his multiple pickoffs on Sumail. We talked about how Slark needs to play out these team fights. He needs to be able to jump to the back line with his Blink Dagger, ignore the Luna, have the rest of his team kite the Luna, and he goes for the back line heroes. That's exactly what he did. And that bottom lane push that allowed them to be able to have such a nice hold. This is going to be another one of those really dangerous points. EG could close out the game because there's lacking these buybacks on OG. But if OG can survive through this, I think they finally have an advantage in the game. If they could just get their buybacks back into play, if they just don't die to this push when they don't have buybacks on two of their cores, then, you know, I think we're good. I think you finally held long enough that you can say you have an advantage in the game.
It certainly is doable. Whether or not it's going to happen, we'll see. I don't know if even EG are... They're probably going to push here in a couple of moments. They're trying to keep all the waves pushed out for now. Like you said, buyback's very important. The Slark, he needs his for sure. And it's still 3 minutes and 45 seconds, which might seem like a long time, but that could go in the blink of an eye if they could survive here. They'll finish the Rax bottom if they can. But
he doesn't have Scotty, right? So he doesn't have like that innate, like really high amount of stats that Slarks usually want to see. And you're facing up against a Dagon 3, a 3-0 Blade Marauna. You know, you could very quickly lose like 1,500 of your HP in a second.
Not to mention how much damage the Luna could pop out, and even the Nightstalker too. But
Dagon 5, never mind.
Yeah, that's frightening. That is frightening. The Veil's going to come out. They want to break down some of these creeps, perhaps, and more importantly, the Ancient Granite Golem, giving you that flat HP bonus of a good old 15%. Which is kind of insane for all these heroes already. It's the Agate Scepter for the Chen. Lark still playing in the front lines right now. OG trying to figure out a way to find an initiation that is successful for them. And they're going to try it. Mantis Tal will go. Pounce is going to connect. Butterfly's still there. They will try to go man mode here. The Shadow Dance is up. The Abyssal Blade. Dusol, it goes, but they had the disruption in time. They don't use that Dream Coil. It looks like they actually did pop it off, but it just doesn't connect. The Earth Splitter might be enough. BKB is going to get off. Now it looks like the Demonic Purge there. No. The Eclipse is turning around. Hex force staff forward. That might keep him alive. They're still going to work here. Now out of the Hex. Still silenced up. Nobody dead it just yet, but the puck may very well fall and will to the Starstorm. He doesn't have buyback. He was the one that used it in the last engagement along with that Slark. And everyone else is super healthy with the exception of the Luna. Now it is a 4 versus 5. Smail taking some hits. You have the Veil up, ready to go for King Crimson. No-Tail looking for more damage here from the Zeus's Lightning Bolts. Now silence again, but he Mantis out of it. There's going to be the Ethereal Blade coming onto the Zeus, still taking some damage, and he'll fall. Gets absolutely dropped by the Chen, the Pendants. Now, Hex is up yet again on this Slark. It is 3 versus 5. I don't know if they can hold on much longer here, Cap, as it's going to be a full set of racks now down bottom taken care of. They had one opportunity to almost bring down that Luna. The Zeus Hulk not connected because of the disruption might have saved that Luna at the end of the day.
Yeah, that was so close. If they'd actually killed the Luna there, then this game would be much different.
This is just getting they got the Rax mid too. And now it's going to be Mega. The Slark. Right, that Ethereal Blade Dagon combo. That's one way to finish off the game, and it certainly is. EG will finish up and make sure that the series is tied at 1 apiece. This best of 5 for Elimination Mode 2.0 is going 4 games, Cap, at least.
Yes, it is. I gotta give major props to OG because I try and paint this game based on the drafts, and for me, I look at the drafts and I say Evil Geniuses should have a very large window as long as they get through the first 15 minutes of about 25 to 45, where they are very dominant. Like I think that's just naturally the way that Evil Geniuses draft just falls, right? Is that it's going to be super dominant and the early to mid game to the late to mid game, right? It's only until you get super late game that maybe crazy things start happening and OG can do a lot with the Slark. But it was like I felt like EG had such an advantage for such a large window of this game that I didn't see how OG were going to be able to possibly be able to hold out long enough to be able to give themselves a super late game win condition, but they almost did it, right? I'm rewatching the stream right now, and if Anna was just able to close that gap a little bit quicker, you know, and he gets an Abyssal Blade while the stun is still there on the Luna, and they kill the Luna, and there's no Eclipse or anything, they just probably run over that team fight really quickly without that Eclipse damage, and the Slark able to just turn on a different hero instantly and start outputting more damage, they probably run over that team fight, and then EG are probably going to be forced into buybacks, right? OG would just be able to push forward, they'd run over that team fight, they'd push forward, they'd force buybacks, and all of a sudden it's going to be EG the ones who are at the serious disadvantage for 5 minutes. They came so close to being able to actually give themselves that win condition that was so hard, in my opinion, because the draft was so set against them.
You're absolutely right. And with that means that EG will take this game and get it to game 3 tied at 1 apiece. We will take a quick break because we have a lot to get to, a lot more Dota to have happen. And of course, with that, we'll get to our panel as soon as we come back. So make sure you guys stick around.
Nick, we need help at B.
What?
We need backup at B, like, right now, dude.
What?